Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Shannon and I am here to do my 37 week pregnancy update. And if you guys are just tuning in, this is my second pregnancy. I am currently pregnant with a little boy. I do have a 16 month old daughter at home, and in a few weeks we will be expecting baby boy. And our little girl will be about 17 months old. So this past week I did have a doctor's appointment. My doctor's office does weekly visits after you are 36 weeks. So now until I deliver, I will be seeing them weekly. So I had an appointment this past Thursday and I gained about a pound, which is normal. I think the last couple weeks of your pregnancy, they expect you to gain at least a pound a week. So everything with my weight was fine. My blood pressure was great. They did give me the results of my group B strep, and I am group B strep negative. I was negative with my first pregnancy. However, they do test every single pregnancy because it can change from pregnancy to pregnancy. And if you are positive, the only thing they will do is give you antibiotics while you're in labor. And if you're not, then there's nothing you have to worry about. So when I went to my doctor's appointment, they did the same thing, and they always measure my stomach and feel for the baby and make sure that he is still head down, which as far as we know, as far as they can tell, he is. So he's just been a lot lower than he's been the past weeks. So I don't know if he's just dropping, which is something that tends to happen. It can happen weeks before you go into labor. It can happen days or even hours before you go into labor. It's definitely one of those things that's different person to person, but I definitely noticed that he is a lot lower. I have had back pain, so much back pain, and I think that it's just the way he's positioned, or it could be, you know, early signs of labor. I had a lot of back labor and a lot of back pain with my daughter, and I do remember that from last time, so it's kind of not the best memory, but I kind of know some things to expect. I don't remember everything entirely, obviously, but I've definitely had a lot of cramping and a lot of ligament pain, especially on the left side. I'm still getting the Braxton Hicks contractions, and sometimes, you know, they'll be pretty frequent and sometimes they won't. The thing to really look for with that is Braxton Hicks kind of are easy to talk through. They don't really hurt too bad. You can just feel your stomach tightening, but if you move around, if you change positions, things like that usually tends to make them stop. It's when your contractions don't really stop that you kind of have to think this might be the start to labor. So I've definitely been paying close attention to all my symptoms as far as the cramping and the back pain, making sure that I don't start spotting or there's not any heavy bleeding, especially since I haven't had an ultrasound since my 20 week anatomy scan. I haven't had to go for any non-stress tests or anything like that. So as far as I know, I don't have placenta previa, but it is something that can happen. And if you have a lot of bleeding and things like that, it's definitely something to be aware of. And it's something that I didn't experience. I didn't experience a lot of bleeding when I went into labor the first time. The only thing I did have was a ton of cramping. It really, honestly, it felt like I was going to get my period. And I remember telling my mom that, and she's like, oh yeah, you're definitely starting to go into labor. It's just a matter of time at this point. And so when I get those period-like cramps, I definitely start to think, is this labor? Is this something that I need to pay closer attention to? And I will say the only thing that was a dead giveaway for me going into labor was I did lose my mucus plug, and I thought that, you know, I wouldn't really be able to tell. You can tell. When you lose your mucus plug, you will know. And for me, that happened, I want to say that morning that I ended up going into the hospital and actually staying in the hospital. So like the day before I had my daughter is when I actually lost it. And then labor definitely really kicked in after that. I've definitely noticed that I don't have as much of an appetite really. It's definitely decreased a lot over the past few days, especially as I get more back pain and more cramping. It's just, I don't really want to eat anything. I just have to eat smaller meals and make sure I make better choices on the foods that I do eat instead of eating a lot of crap, which doesn't make me feel any better either. This past week, because of how I've been feeling, I made sure to pack my hospital bag. The baby's bag is packed, and I just have to get diapers for my daughter's bag. Otherwise, it's just throwing the last minute things in and we will be good to go. Since this past week was my first week off of work, I was able to, you know, start working on the nursery again and kind of get more things organized. But it seems the more I try and work in that room, the more things I find and the more stuff that ends up being thrown in there just to get it out of the way in the rest of the house. I have noticed that I'm not as swollen. My hands haven't been as swollen, and so I did end up putting my wedding rings back on and things like that, just because I'm not too concerned with how much I've been swelling. And since my blood pressure's been fine, I haven't really noticed the need to really take them off and keep them off. I still can't believe that I am 3 weeks, well, now I'm a few days less than 3 weeks away from my due date, which is crazy, and I can't believe how much faster it's gone being my second pregnancy. And it's just, I feel like I should be so much more prepared, but I feel less prepared this time because I don't really know what to expect from my daughter. And I definitely think transitioning from one kid to two kids isn't as terrible as maybe transitioning to more kids, but it's definitely going to be an adjustment. And she is just getting to the point where she is throwing temper tantrums and fits, and it might just be because she knows that the baby's coming and she doesn't want to feel replaced, so she's making sure she gets attention, whether it's positive attention or negative attention. So that's been really hard for my husband and I to deal with and try and figure out the best solution for that. And it's just something that I guess we're just gonna have to take day by day. I know I am just gonna be so exhausted in the first couple weeks, and then hopefully things will adjust to a new schedule and we'll kind of figure out how things are gonna go. All right, so that is everything for my 37-week pregnancy update. Now I'll show you guys my belly. So I don't know if you guys will be able to tell, but he's definitely a lot lower. Be able to tell maybe when I show you without my shirt. We are getting huge though. So definitely, he's not up here. He's definitely down here. Thank you so much for watching. Again, if you have any questions, any tips, please leave them in the comments below. And I will see you next time.